Hello students, in the last class we discussed the essay of Francis Bacon of Studies. Today we will discuss about Bertrand Russell. Bertrand Russell, because we have Bertrand Russell's essay Knowledge and Wisdom in our syllabus. So first of all we will discuss about Bertrand Russell, who Bertrand Russell is. Bertrand Arthur William Russell, it was the full name of Bertrand Russell. He was 3rd Earl Russell. He born in 1872 and he died in 1970. He was a British philosopher, writer, social critic and political activist. In the early 20th century, Russell led the British revolt against idealism. He is considered one of the founders of analytic philosophy. Russell was a mathematician, logician, and he wrote mathematics books. But his essays are very prominent in literature because his essays gives the general wisdom of human life. Russell was an anti-war activist and went to prison for his pacifism during World War I. Due to anti-war activism, he opposed the First World War. So he has to go to prison due to his anti-war activities. He did conclude that the war against Adolf Hitler was necessary, lesser of two evils. He won the Nobel Prize in Literature in 1950. He was a Nobel laureate because he received a Nobel Prize in 1950. In recognition of his varied and significant writing in which he champions humanitarian ideals and freedom of thoughts, his famous writings are Roads to Freedom, Principia Mathematica, Marriage and Morals, The Conquest of Happiness, etc. And these are some of his famous writings. Here he defines knowledge and wisdom in his essay Knowledge and Wisdom. He defines knowledge and wisdom. He says that life experience of a person processes knowledge into wisdom. Knowledge, comprehensive reason, pursuit of purpose, emancipation of freedom and impartiality in opinions and views are what constitute wisdom. This was his famous essay that we will study in next class. Russell's contribution to logic, epistemology and the philosophy of mathematics established him as one of the foremost philosophers of the 20th century. To the general public, however, he was best known as a campaigner for peace and as a popular writer on social, political and moral subjects. During a long, productive and often turbulent life, he published more than 70 books and about 2,000 articles. He became involved in innumerable public controversies and was honored and reviled in almost equal measures throughout the world. Russell's article on the philosophical consequences of relativity appeared in the 13th edition of Encyclopedia Britannica. He was born in Ravenscroft, the country home of his parents. He belonged to an aristocratic family. His grandfather, Lord John Russell, was the youngest son of the 6th Duke of Bedford. In 1861, after a long and distinguished political career in which he served twice as Prime Minister, Lord Russell was ennobled by Queen Victoria, becoming the first Earl Russell. Bertrand Russell became the 3rd Earl Russell in 1931, after his elder brother Frank died childless. Russell's early life was marked by tragedy and bereavement. By the time he was age 6, his sister Rachel, his parents and his grandfather had all died and he and Frank were left in the care of grandmother. Countess Russell, though Frank was sent to Winchester School, Burton was educated privately at home, and his childhood, to his later great regret, was spent largely in isolation from other children. Intellectually precocious, he became absorbed in mathematics from an early age and found the experience of learning geometry at the age of 11 as dazzling as first love, because it introduced him to intoxicating possibility of certain... intoxicating possibility of certain demonstrable knowledge. This led him to imagine that all knowledge might be provided with such secure foundations, a hope that lay at the very heart of his motivations as a philosopher. His earliest philosophical work was written during his adolescence and records the skeptical doubt that led him to abandon the Christian faith in which he had been brought up by his grandmother. In 1890, Russell's isolation came to an end when he entered Trinity College, University of Cambridge, to study mathematics. There he made lifelong friends through his membership in the famously secretive student society, the Epistles, whose members included some of the most influential philosophers of the day. Inspired by his discussion with this group, Russell abandoned mathematics for philosophy and won a fellowship at Trinity on the strength of a thesis entitled An Essay on the Foundation of Geometry. This was also published. He followed Kant's Critique of Pure Reason. This work presented a sophisticated idealist theory that viewed geometry as a description of the structure of vital institution. But in Russell, he was sympathetic to the reformist aims of German socialist movement. And it included some trenchant and far-sighted criticism of Marxist dogmas. And Burton Russell's he wrote one on the philosophy of the sciences, the other on social and political questions. At last, as he later put it, I would achieve a Hegelian synthesis in an encyclopedic work dealing equally with theory and practice. He did in fact come to write on all the subjects he intended, but not in the form that he envisaged. Shortly after finishing his book on geometry, he abandoned the metaphysical idealism that was to have provided the framework for his grand synthesis. Russell's abandonment of idealism is customarily attributed to the influence of his friend and fellow G. Moore. A much greater influence on his thought at this time, however, was a group of German mathematicians that included George Cantor, Richard Dedekind, whose work was aimed at providing mathematics with a set of logically rigorous foundation. For Russell, the success in this endeavor was of a numerous philosophical as well as mathematical significance. Indeed, he described it as the greatest triumph of which our age has to boast. After becoming famous, Russell abandoned all vestiges of his earlier idealism and adopted the view which he was to hold for the rest of his life, that analysis rather than synthesis was the surest method of philosophy, and therefore all the grand system building of previous philosophers was misconceived. In arguing for this view with passion and actuality, Russell exerted a profound influence on the entire tradition of English-speaking analytic philosophy, bequeathing to its characteristic style, method, and tone. Inspired by the work of the mathematicians whom he so greatly admired, Russell conceived the idea of demonstrating that mathematics not only had logically rigorous foundation, but also that it was in its entirely nothing but logic. So, now we can know that Burton Russell was more mathematician than a literary person, but his essays are very popular and he became famous in a literary area also. In the next class, we will discuss his essay, Wisdom, Knowledge and Wisdom. It is famous for defining what is knowledge and what is wisdom. Thank you.